So this poem is called End of the Road. Let's make it big. Out with the old.
Out with the old.
And into the blue. Have you ever felt your heart calling you somewhere new? Have you ever stretched the truth, squeezed the juice out of a cliche just so you could say you searched the world to find someone who really sees you? I searched for miles and miles, for years and years. I drove all over this country, the country of my heart. I drove across the deserts and the floodplains, across the cattle-trod clay clods with tea tree veins and the rivers running in song from the rock and the rain. I walked through dry forests of eucalypts who were passing secrets in their fingertips. I went to find the mind in the fullness of silence. I sat down in valleys that awaken the chant of ancestors, the dance of lorikeets in wet subtropical heat where the breath of the clouds settles on your face. I chased that road as far as it would go. But before I even knew it was done, I had come to the final, startling edge of land, end of the road, the jumping off place, the unknown. And I felt calm and wild and all at once completely at home, because suddenly there was nowhere else to go. No more driving, no more striving, no more starting or ending or mending the fact that whenever I write a love poem, it always comes out as a landscape. Landscapes that trace the country of my heart. So out with the old.
Out with the old.
And into the new. Because when I come to the sea, what is offered to me is the whole lot. The whole country, from the centre to the coast, is reflected in a single drop. When I stop, I see and hear and smell the story of the heart in its journey, in the wind that moves through me, in the singing skin, in the blue sea. If you want to hold on to a single drop, you should fling it into the ocean. Out with the old.
Out with the old.
And into the blue. And we have ventured so soon, so far into that sovereign territory where you and I could just vanish without a trace, where our separateness has no place, where the slightest shift would just tip us in to where the darkening waves are our clouds and the sea things are kings, and yet that horizon is so fabulously precise. It leaves us here, precarious and alive. So landscape is what I get when I try to write about love, but I trust it. In a deep down old way, the way I trust the earth to meet my feet with every step I take into the new, where you meet me and we make our forever home.